Hey YouTube, my name is Dan and this is a short free extract of my longer course called Animated Infographics and Data Visualization. That course, along with the free exercise files for this particular video and a free downloadable cheat sheet, can be found at bringyourownlaptop.com. Hello beautiful people, in this video we are going to look at CC libraries and why they're awesome for your infographic and data visualization work. Okay, you can see them over here. We're going to bring in colors and icons and all sorts of cool stuff. We're going to work a little bit with Illustrator. Let's go and check out the awesomeness now in this video. Okay, first things first, we're going to open up the file that I've got the icons in. Okay, so I am not in After Effects or anything, I'm just in the Finder in Mac. So if you're on a Windows PC, just go to your desktop and try and find the exercise files. Open up 01 icon pop, open up 01icons.ai, an Adobe Illustrator file. Now when it comes to Illustrator and After Effects, they just can't live without each other. Illustrator is designed to make icons and graphics and illustrations, and After Effects can do it kind of badly. Okay, so even though you might not have any Illustrator skills, it's not going to be that hard for what we need to use it for. So these are icons that somebody else has made. Check out one of my Illustrator courses if you want to get into this in more detail. But what we're going to do is we're going to reset our workspace just to make sure it's like yours. So we can get started, reset essentials. Okay, now first thing we want to do is we're going to look at something called libraries. So you might be using the Adobe Creative Cloud now, but ignoring these libraries. They keep popping up and you're like, go away. This is the video that's going to convince you that they are super awesome and you should start using them, especially with After Effects. So first thing we're going to do is you probably go to My Library, and like me, it's probably filled with junk or empty if you're not using it. Okay, so we're going to go down to, see it says My Library. If you can't see libraries, go to Window. There he is there, Libraries. And click My Library and go down, Create New Library. Okay, and this one here is going to be Infographic Animation Course BYOL. Okay, and what I'll do is I'll add a link to the screen right here. Okay, this link, that link there, okay, that will link you to this library. Click on the link, it'll take you through, you'll have to sign in with your Adobe password, and magically you'll have this exact same one that we're creating here. If you don't want to do that, don't worry, you don't have to. We'll create our own as you go along. So we've created our new library. It says drag and drop assets, easy. So what we're going to do is say you, so I've selected it all, grab my black arrow, selected a box around it all, grab them all, just dump it in there. I'm going to double click the word artwork one, and this is going to be icon one house. Okay, I never name them. I just leave them whatever they come through as, but we're going to be super official here. I want you to do what I say, but not as I do type thing. Cool, so we're going to drag these along. Okay, I'm going to speed this up, or at least Taylor or Jason is. So ready, steady, go. Phew, that's the reason I don't rename them. Takes forever. But I'm going to share this with you, so I wanted to make it look nice. Cool. So why is it so good? You're like, awesome, you've chucked them into that box there. What's really cool is if we jump to After Effects now. Hold on. Okay, and in here, there's libraries. Okay, and the cool thing about libraries is in here, there's my infographic one that I've made. Hey, and there's all my icons. I can start dragging them out. Okay, and you still might not be super impressed. What you can do though is you can right click it and say I want to edit it. Open and set up back in Illustrator. It's not the same thing, okay, it's like a copy of that original one. But I can go into here and I can say, actually, this thing here, if you know Illustrator, you can start editing things. I'm not sure what I'm doing. Okay, I'm wrecking it. But if I hit save, it updates there. And look over here, I've updated there and wrecked it. Okay, so I'm going to go back into here. I'm going to undo all that wrecking. Hit save again, close it down. And notice that it's here, it's fine. Okay, so it's connected between all these products. So it's great for things like logos for your business. Okay, I've got ones in here for lots of different projects and companies because it saves me having to go off and try and find them on my hard drive. Now, what I'm gonna do for this course to make life a little easier with libraries is that they're kind of tied in with all these panels that I use quite a bit. Now, what I've got actually is another screen. It's just over here. You can't see it, okay, but there's a big screen next to this screen, and I often will put these panels over there. And what you can do is, let's say the library, grab the word library, click, hold and drag it. Okay, and you can go and drag it over to this panel here. You can't see it here, but that's where I stick it. Okay, but what I'm gonna do so you can keep seeing what I'm doing is I'm dragging it. You can see all these weird things. It means that it's gonna go above, below, next to it. I want it next to it, this bit here. Okay, so I'm gonna have these guys so we can get to my character panel paragraphs, and over here under my libraries, okay, it's a bit small. Come here, drag it out. Here we go there, so I can see stuff. And I wanna make it just a little bit wider. Cool. So CC libraries are awesome for some, like that's pretty cool. The other nice thing is that Premiere, the exact same library pairs, Photoshop. So you're kind of connecting them all together. It doesn't have to be icons. You can drag stuff in from Photoshop. You can drag videos into here. You can drag any sort of thing. And by any sort of thing, let's go check out what else we can drag. Let's jump back into Illustrator. So here in Illustrator, I'm gonna grab my white arrow. Okay, and I'm gonna click on this kind of circle around the outside. You can see that's the fill color. I would like that to be part of this library. And you can do it by clicking this plus button down the bottom. And you can, by default, it's probably got all of these selected. It'll bring in the graphic, which is my icon, the fill and stroke color. I don't need the stroke color because it's white, and I don't need the graphic because I've already got it. I'm gonna click add. There's just the color swatch. It's the perfect swatch to match that. If you've got your brand colors for your company, okay, you can go and do that. So I'm gonna go through and add all of these colors. Okay, these are the colors I'm gonna use for my project. We're not going to now, but you can add things like paragraph styles and bunches of text and character styles, all sorts of awesome things end up in libraries. One more thing before we go is that if you are using libraries and you're at a company and you're like, oh, this would be awesome, imagine if I could share it with someone. Okay, up under libraries here, there's a little swipey lines here, the hamburger menu, click on that and go to collaborate. Collaborates and share link, they sound the same. Collaborate will mean I can share it with my colleague next to me. Okay, so Malcolm's there and I say collaborate with him and he can add, remove, delete and edit because I trust him, he knows what he's doing. Okay, I wouldn't though. Malcolm is an amazing developer, but not with my library. But anyway, let's say I just need to share it because I'm like, Malcolm's gonna ruin this. I need to just share a link, okay? And that means he can get it, he can see it, but he can't mess with it, okay? So it's up to you how you wanna do it. That link that I had earlier in this, okay, is the one I went share link, okay? And I went and turned it on to be public. You can click on that and work through it. It's not hard to do, okay? All right, so now back over to After Effects. Now, why did we come back over here? I'm not sure. Okay, we're done for this video. Let's move on to the next one. Hey there, what'd you think? If you liked the video, hit the like button, that'd be great. Also consider subscribing to my channel. Now this is a free part of a longer course. You can check that out on bringyourownlaptop.com. On that site is a free downloadable, printable PDF cheat sheet, okay, to help you with your infographics and data visualization. Also on that site is a bunch of other courses as well. So go check it out, bringyourownlaptop.com. Bye now.